In this video, we will demonstrate how to use the LiveScribe Player to listen to notes that have been exported from the Echo Desktop software. Whether you've exported your notes to your computer or through email to a friend, whoever wants to read the notes with the recording will need to access the LiveScribe Player that's available online through a web browser. So when somebody receives the email with your notes attached and they open it up, they're going to see a message that says, please download this PDF to your computer and go to the livescribe.com player. So I'll click on File, Save As, and I'm going to save this to to my computer. And now I should see the lecture notes that I received by email on my computer. And when I click on this file, there's a link at the top of the file to the internet. And if I click on that, it'll ask me whether I want this PDF document to connect to the LiveScribe Player website, and I'm going to say allow. And now my web browser should open up with LiveScribe Player, and I'm just going to close this PDF file, because to open this PDF within the player now I can just simply drag and drop the file that I saved to my computer into the web browser. So I'll go ahead and do that now. So let me try this one. So make sure when you're saving the lecture and recording to your desktop or to someplace on your computer that you save it as a LiveScribe PDF, or else it will not open within the LiveScribe Player. So now I've dragged and dropped this file into the LiveScribe Player, and I should see the notes as they appear, and I can click on play and it'll start playing my notes from the beginning. Now the LiveScribe Player has a few options that are similar to the Echo Desktop software. In the top right hand corner of the screen, if I click on that, so a couple features that are different are that in the right hand corner in the settings menu, I can choose whether or not all of the notes are going to appear instantly on the screen, even though I'm not listening to the recording that goes with them. So I can just listen to the recording without seeing the notes that are going to come later by clicking on the first checkbox. I can also enable the auto page turn so that when I reach the end of page one, it'll take me to the next page. Since I've only shared one note and I've opened it opened up only one page of notes, this feature is not going to work at all for me because there's only one page of notes for me to listen to. Another option that I have within the player is I can choose whether I want the notes that I'm making when I'm listening to the recording appear in a blue outline, a red outline, or a different color outline color. Okay. Also on the bottom I can change the magnification so that I can see my notes as bigger or smaller. I can jump forward 10 seconds within the recording. I see down here on the bottom that this is a 50-minute recording. I can also use the scroll bar on the bottom just to go directly to a part of the recording that I want. And then finally, similar to the Echo Desktop software, in the bottom right corner of the screen, I have an option to change the playback speed. For more information about assistive technology and alternate media at Taft College, please call 661-763-7799. Also visit our website at www.taftcollege.edu/tcwp/accessibility. There you can find our bi-monthly Access Technology Update newsletter with more information about assistive technology. Also contact Joseph Polizzotto at jpolizzotto@taftcollege.edu or call him at 661-763-7977. Thank you very much for watching.